My name is Jamie Murray, and I shape Jamie Murray Custom Surfboards in Santa Rosa, California. I think primarily what makes Northern California unique is its scenic beauty. I think most of our development up here in Northern California is away from the coastline, and so it feels untouched. You know, I think the difficulties in Northern California are threefold. One is the waves are not user-friendly at all up here. They're cold, the water's cold, the waves can be pretty powerful and pretty heavy, and we don't have a lot of beginner spots. And so that, you know, dissuades a lot of potential surfers right there, and it's mostly unforgiving and punishing in terms of wave quality. You know, one of the things that separates hand-shaped boards from non-hand-shaped boards and the boards that I'm doing up here versus boards that maybe other people are doing in close proximity is that I try to invite the purchaser into the process as much as possible. I think that, you know, as we see this influx of imported boards, people are really looking at sort of the tradition of surfing and the tradition of surfboard shaping. People want to get involved. They want to see how things are made. There's no other sport that I can think of where you can have a professional or semi-professional make a custom piece of equipment for you that you can use every day. This is the first tool that I use when shaping the board. I try to use this tool as much as possible. The surfboard blank arrives with a thick crust on it, and so the planer takes the crust off. The second step, bringing the board to thickness, is done with the power planer as well as the foil, which is the thickness flow from nose to tail of the surfboard. I use the planer to shape the rocker into the board if I have to make any rocker adjustments. I put a lot of V into most of my boards, which is a convex bottom shape. The panel V allows the board to go easier from rail to rail. I shape that in with the power planer. I use V in a lot of boards up here on the North Coast because some people think it's a drag element that slows the board down a little bit. It's okay for the beach break that we have up here. We're not really worried about creating speed. Up here, what we're really interested in doing is controlling the speed that the wave provides. So I do all but what's called the finish shaping with the power planer. So the next step after the board is brought to thickness, its skin, is to lay out the dimensions of the board, and I use a layout square for that. Then I use a template to get the right curves for the board. Then I cut it out with a handsaw held almost as vertically as possible as you can get. The vertical line of the board is really crucial over here to keeping the board true. If it's at all off, it affects the shape of the rail. Rails play a pretty crucial role in determining how not only the board will float, but how the board will ride. A thicker rail, the board will sit a little bit higher on the water. It'll be a little bit more difficult to engage going in and out of turns. A rounder rail, round rails attract water. They provide friction across the surface, a curved surface that attracts the water to it. After I cut the board out, I true up the outline of the board with a couple different sanding tools. It gives it a pretty rough finish, and then I'll go along with some 36 grit sandpaper and really just sort of true up the outline that way. If there are any scratches or nicks or scuffs or anything like that, it tends to show in a resin tint, so I'll take these to as fine a grit as I possibly can. And then after we use the sandpaper, we move on to the sanding screens, and these are great for rails and for tighter curves in the surfboard, and these will help knock some of the bigger curves out of the marks left by tools and get a really fine finish on the board. After the board's been finished, I'll usually take a few pictures and send them off to the client, and we'll talk about where they want logos. If it's a clear surfboard, I'll laminate the logos on myself. After the logos are on, I will load it up carefully and drive it down to Santa Cruz, where Almar Surfworks does all of my fiberglassing.
I shape because I can't
imagine not doing it. It's sort of the first thing that I'm thinking about when I wake up in the morning, the last thing I'm thinking about when I fall asleep at night. I imagine through most points of the day, I'm constantly returning to surfboard design in my head and shaping surfboards.
Sonoma Coast Surf Shop in Petaluma and also a 2 Mile Surf Shop in Bolinas, California. We're gonna talk about local shaper from Santa Rosa, Jamie Murray. He produces some pretty epic, vintage-like, but high-end surfboards. First board that we have in here is kind of an egg shape, kind of candy apple red, with a pretty tight pintail, classic 2+1 setup. 8.6, a mini longboard egg, a little bit more high performance than like your standard nose rider. Gives you a good option to have a single fin, just ride it like that, or put in two side bites for a little bit more control. This is a 9.6, another custom Jamie Murray shape. Curves it, ride the nose, just a standard single fin, but nothing really standard about the shape. I mean, got a really nice, heavy, thick stringer here. Just beautiful contours. Put your hand on something like this and you know what it was built for.
One of the differences that I'd like to make is allowing people, giving people the opportunity to participate in cottage industry, where, you know, I've always been fascinated by this notion that during the 50s, during the 60s, during the 70s, you had shapers sort of in every area that knew that area well, that designed and shaped boards for that particular area, that surfed with their customers, that were sort of just a part of the local surf scene.